I'm Robert Sabelli, Chief Business Development Officer at Altasciences. Over the past decade or so, Altasciences has been working closely with our sponsors to create a unique model that moves their drug development program seamlessly across the various phases of development. The concept of successful integration model requires the implementation of specialized tools, proprietary software, and the process to have various divisions communicating with one another, as well as an executive leadership team fostering a culture of mindset of integration. That last piece is the X factor to ensuring sustainability and flexibility for our sponsors, allowing them to navigate our organization effortlessly and engage at any entry point. Today, I'm joined by many of our executive leaders across Altasciences who work continuously hand in hand to successfully conduct our sponsors' various studies and our programs across our organization. How often do you communicate with one another, and in what situations do you get together to support our sponsors' needs?
I think I speak to these guys probably almost every day, at least one or two groups, and we're getting together to discuss not just programs, but individual studies, client needs across the board. Everybody is so client-focused and so focused on the delivery of our commitments that it is, it's really great to work together with this team. Everyone's got a single focus, and nobody takes priority of over another, which is really excellent. I've worked in places before where that's not the case, but you know, you can have a problem in another business unit, another division, and everyone's going to work together for that solution. I think what's also great is even if we're not involved in a program or a study as a business unit, we act as consultants for each other often, which is really, really helpful in moving a sponsor's concerns or needs forward, and it just provides great support for all of us internally and for our sponsors.
We have a very good collaboration across the units, and they bring us in early, so we can have those early discussions with our clients as they work on developing their preclinical and clinical programs. You know, whether it's a small molecule or a large molecule, we're seeing a lot of diversity in what they need for their drug development program. For example, in gene therapy which is a really hot topic right now, our clients might need PCR biodistribution analysis. They might have some biomarkers they want to work on, and immunogenicity assays and PK assays, and all of those we're working with our clients with the preclinical in-life support or the clinical, and we're working to make their timelines and making sure they have everything they need for their regulatory submissions.
Yeah, and being able to pull together as one team for our sponsors and to be able to do that quickly, it's really exciting. When I get that ping from Steve or someone on his team and his sponsor is facing challenges with their formulation, being able to leverage the CDMO facility and bring us in and look at those challenges and be able to overcome whatever challenges they are, getting to the end goal, getting there quickly, getting the tox trial back on track, it's really exciting for us, and that's why we do what we do.
Thank you so much for joining me. Incredible information, valuable information, and for all those who are watching, thank you very much and have a great day.